We have with us Sandeep Aggarwal. He is the co-chairman Telecom Export Promotion Council, and he is also the managing director of Paramount Communications Limited. Paramount is a $100 million company, and of this they export around 20 crore from the export market. First, sir, about the event, how many delegates, how many countries people have participated?
Well, there are more than 140 delegates from 30 plus countries, and as you can see, it was full, and people are very much interested now working with India. But India and the telecom demand is booming, and all the companies are actually full in capacity. But anyways, we are not keeping that for delaying export growth. So probably, if and when there is a demand from other countries, from India, we will be interested in doing that. Although what we are looking right now is doing a structured thing. Just selling cables probably may not be the right idea. We want to do the complete EPC work, and probably using the TPC as the engine. What we want is, we want that all the Indian companies together work together and as a whole go into the country, take over the telecom assets of those country, and we are able to produce the world-class telecom network for them. So we install it, we manage it, we do everything for them, but keep them teaching it to them also. But while we do that, it grows in their country, and that is where the volume and the value will come. Selling in an individual item will only add a small value to the whole business.
So this is your first event as co-chairman of TPC.
Yeah.
So for in this event, what's the business that you feel would be coming for Indian companies?
Well, see, what the TPC role is mainly to facilitate people to meet their customers, because it's a competitive world, and for every type of manufacturing goods which is done here, there can be 3 to 5 different companies. So there's a lot of competition, and so we really do not ask our members that whom they did business with, how much they did business with. Yes, we can collate some data keep it away from the prying eyes, and then give that data to the government and to media. So we are collating the data of what people are selling, although we are not too much nosy into our members, whom they sell to, what they sell, how much they sell. We really want that every company here is meeting with at least 10 to 20 different companies. So we hope that apart from getting immediate business, the depth of Indian industry will be felt by these companies. And we have seen that in every such event, the order book which is coming to Indian companies is growing. So we are not putting a very fine number on that right now, but this is what is happening. And as I said, the whole idea is to then, now we have shown them that we are capable, now go as a whole and to take their full business. That's what we want.
In terms of your export potential of your companies or Paramount Cables,
as I said, telecom, we are actually, as of today, we are having our order books full for the next 6 to 8 months in India itself. We are expanding our capacities, and therefore we are looking at exports. We are exporting to various countries in the Southeast Asia and Nepal. South Asia means Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and also Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. We have exported to Middle East. We have exported to Nigeria. We have exported to Eastern Africa also. So we are exporting regularly to the UK, and now we have just started exporting to the US. So US is basically a very big emerging market. Now you'll say, how come a US is an emerging market? Okay. So for India, it is an emerging market because US wanted to buy everything from Chinese. Mm-hmm. Now with this Trump and the China war, they want to broad base their purchases. So India becomes a very important center for them. So that's why we are we just started getting big orders from US. So let's hope that those big means for us, initial order they are big. But let's see how they it turns up. We probably believe it's going to be big.
What are the products that you are looking from an export point of view from Paramount?
See, we are not only doing optical fiber cables, we are doing optical fiber cables, we are doing power cables, we are doing building wires, we are doing submarine cables, we are doing OPGW cables, and we are into various kind of products. So we are one of the biggest suppliers to the Indian Railways also for optical fiber cables, for telecom cables called quad cables, for signaling cables. So you name it, we do it.
As a co-chairman of TPC, what's your vision for TPC?
So, well, I've got 2 years as co-chairman for TPC, and my vision is that a consortium of Indian companies take up BharatNet-like projects in Cambodia, in Vietnam, in Burma, in Nigeria, in Ghana, in various countries of Africa and Southeast Asia. And we are able to provide them cost-effective service, secure service, away from the Chinese and the American prying eyes, mm-hmm. because all these countries have burned their fingers with America meddling into their affairs, or now China meddling into their affairs. India does not have any of such issues, and then the private companies are going there who are not really reporting to the government. So therefore, the most secure business these countries can do is with the Indian companies. And I hope and pray that we will have $1 billion exports of these kind of EPC projects starting from 2 years from now, and probably it will grow at a rate of at least 20-25% per annum in the next 20 years. So you can just think about what the amount will be after 20 years. And that is, India will get a 25% stake in the world EPC work. That is what my vision is. And that would be the TEPC vision for these 2 years too.
Thanks.